Imagining Arizona without John McCain is like picturing an Arizona without the Grand Canyon.
It has been 3 years since Arizona's Senator John McCain lost his battle to brain cancer. Senator McCain was diagnosed with glioblastoma in July of 2017. And the disease is the most common and deadliest form of brain cancer. Despite how common it may be, little progress has been made, with only one drug being approved by the FDA in the past 3 decades. So just think of that. Dr. Nader Sanai is the director and neurological oncologist of the Ivy Brain Tumor Center, and he joins us this morning to talk a little bit about the progress we continue to hope to make in this fight. Thank you so much for joining us, Dr. Sanai.
Thank you for having me.
Tell me about some of the challenges, first off, of being able to find a medication, a drug that can fight this.
Well, as you mentioned, there are hundreds of thousands of patients every year diagnosed with a brain tumor. And for many of them, they have the exact cancer type as Senator McCain and others, which is glioblastoma. This is today an incurable tumor for most patients. And as you mentioned, few drugs have been approved in the last 3 decades. The Ivy Center here at the Barrow in Phoenix is the busiest brain tumor center in the world. And as a consequence, we've really taken it upon ourselves to focus on drug development, which means partnering with industry, developing innovative new trials, so patients with brain cancer that are facing a really limited timeline will have opportunities to try new things and get different outcomes from those that preceded them.
Trials are so important, of course, in this effort to find a cure. Tell me about some of the clinical trials that you guys are taking part in, because it's only here in some of them that you can be a part of this.
Well, as you can imagine, there has been progress with cancer drugs for other types of cancer, but for brain cancer, one of the big problems is that new drugs typically don't get into the brain because your brain is designed to keep things out. So our phase zero trials here at the Ivy Center focus on identifying drugs that in individual patients are getting to their cancers and making sure that those drugs are actually doing something in their cancer. And we establish those things before we put them on the drug long-term. So for those of us or with family members or are personally dealing with cancer, we know that the waiting game around whether a new drug is going to work is really a difficult, difficult experience. And so we really cut that down so that within days of an operation, we know exactly if a drug is doing something in a particular patient's tumor.
And scary to think that nearly 84,000 more people will be diagnosed with brain cancer alone this year. What do you tell to families who are dealing with this? How do you give them hope?
Well, the first thing we tell every family is, this is your first time going through it, it's not ours. This is what we do, and we're gonna bring to bear every technology, every specialist imaginable to navigate you through this. So the first step is just to stabilize the situation, give them some context, and then, like you mentioned, point out that there is a way through this, that it is not a death sentence for every patient. And in fact, you can survive. We just need to align everything perfectly to give you an opportunity to do that. So, you know, we're with patients and their families and caregivers every step of the way. It's important that they understand there's a team behind them, and we're going to bring to them the newest drugs, things that have recently been developed, things that sometimes haven't even been trialed in brain cancer patients before, so that we can get them a different outcome.
Dr. Sanai with Barrows, thank you so much for joining us this morning and shedding some light on the fight against brain cancer and the fight to find a cure. We appreciate your time this morning.
Thank you.